Welcome to ProTradeCraft's Weatherization Nation, a show about building smart from the start. Last week, we were flashing a window with flexible flashing.
Work it as we go to avoid any dimpling in the corners. Sometimes using a framing square works out pretty well.
We talked about the importance of rolling flashing tapes into their substrates before we stuck the window in the hole and sealed it into the home wrap using flashing tape and smart overlapping. This week, we're jumping up on the roof to try out a high-tech underlayment with a no-skid surface. But before we test out the skid resistance, let's go to Animation Land, where it's always safe and sunny. First, the team flashed the edges of the existing roof with peel-and-stick membrane before framing the addition roof. With the new roof framed, we can turn to sealing the critical spots against water infiltration, beginning at the eave and folding the edge of the membrane down over the edge of the roof sheathing. This is a great practice for places with sideways rain, ice dams, or both. Now, cover the rakes with peel and stick membrane, folding it up the existing roof, but not too far. This intersection will be sealed later, and this rake flashing should not extend above the upper edge of that membrane. But first, we're going to flash the eave with a metal drip edge flashing and install the roofing membrane over it along the bottom edge of the roof. Cap staples are recommended on this underlayment, every 12 inches along the bottom and every 24 inches in the middle. For high wind zones, put a fastener everywhere you see a marking on the underlayment. For all but low slope roofs, overlap each course 4 inches and the seams 6 inches. Now, a strip of membrane can seal this intersection of roofs while also sealing the top of the underlayment. Above that flashing, the underlayment continues to the ridge. Drip edge flashing should be run up the rakes over the edge of the ProTech underlayment. Up on the roof in the real world, the roofers begin the process. To keep the peel and stick in a straight line, they snap a line and follow it. As he aligns the sheet, he pulls a little piece of the release sheet, which allows him to stick it in place while his partner positions the long end. He positions the bottom corner, and then they set the sheet on the line and peel off one side of the release sheet. Staple the sheet down to hold it while the adhesive sets up, and then he peels off the second half of the release sheet. Now they can roll out the ProTech underlayment. Because this roof is a lower slope than 4 and 12, they must overlap the courses significantly. The normal overlap is 4 inches, but for slopes lower than a 4 pitch, the overlap is 18 inches. Half the width of the roll. He staples the bottom corner, stretches the roll out, and staples it off using button cap staples. ProTech will accept regular slap staples if the roof is going to be covered right away. Here's a tip. If you don't know about hook blades, you should. They're an excellent way to cut roofing products without damaging the layers below. The guys work their way up the roof to the peak, and they call it a day. Next week, we're going to jump back off the roof and cover the walls with a high-tech rain screen product called Drain Vent. It creates a drainage space behind the siding so that any water sneaking back there can be directed away from the house.